In order to mentally prepare the guys to perform, we try to coach them along the way of what their ultimate performance is going to be.
You can't get in a negative headspace for that, because that just wouldn't set you up successfully for the show.
So we're constantly preparing them for their finals kinds of performances, and really any performance in front of an audience, right? So we remind them that there's gonna be people in the stands, hundreds of people, thousands of people, they're gonna be watching you on TV, you know? So kind of setting them up for that mental preparation of, a lot of people are gonna watch me and I wanna look great in front of all of them because this is fun and I like doing this and I wanna show off how much fun I'm having and how great of a performer I can be.
I have to like get fired up for what we're about to do. You have to find the middle ground of, okay, I'm really excited to do this, but at the same time, I'm not going overboard to where it's out of control and frantic.
We try to stay consistent with how we approach things, right? So when we wake up, we try to do the same kinds of things in a rehearsal setting and then the same things during a warm-up situation so that they're always prepared. They always kind of know what's coming up next so that it's never unpredictable.
Up, down, up, down, up, down, out, out, out. 9, 10, 1, 2, and 5, and 8, and 10, and 1.
To get things as looking as perfect as possible, we just rep things over and over again and keep reinforcing the same kinds of information. Having that consistent kind of dialogue with the members helps them to understand information in the same way from person to person.
We basically do the show and we segment it into different sections. Sometimes it'll be 2 counts, sometimes it'll be 10 sets. You know, we basically dissect it and make sure that everybody is aware of what their responsibilities are.
So we try to rep things in small chunks, and then once that is successful, then we make those chunks bigger and bigger and bigger to get things as perfect as possible. And then we add on additional layers of detail to continue to refine those moments. Well, I think that with this program in particular, this year, I think the Color Guard plays a really important part of the story of the show.
To an initiation process, you have the people that have been initiated and then you have the initiates. So without one or the other, it wouldn't be the process that it is.
Within like the whole secret society, we represent the group of people going from being outside to becoming part of the inside group of people. So there's this really explicit visual interpretation of outside versus inside, or us versus them, yet we're all part of the same team.